Welcome to the library. In this quick tutorial, we will review the tool Google Scholar and discuss its features. We will also cover how to link NCU Library to Google Scholar and take advantage of other helpful settings. Additionally, we will discuss how to use the basic and advanced search, as well as how to navigate the search results page. Google Scholar is a freely accessible web search engine that allows you to broadly search for scholarly literature across many disciplines and sources. It includes articles, theses, books, abstracts, and court opinions from academic publishers, professional societies, online repositories, universities, and other websites. While NCU Library provides you with free and immediate access to a number of electronic resources, Google Scholar can help you expand your search for academic resources beyond what is available through our library databases. To access Google Scholar, open an internet browser window and type the following URL into the address bar: www.scholar.google.com. Before you even begin searching, we recommend linking NCU Library to your Google Scholar search. Select Settings from the drop-down menu found by clicking on the three horizontal bars in the above left corner. Next, click on the Library Links tab. In the search box displayed, type North Central University, then click the search button. North Central University full text at NCU should now appear below the search box. Checkmark the box next to this text, then click Save. You have now successfully linked NCU Library to Google Scholar. There are two important items to note here. First, you may link up to 5 libraries on Google Scholar. WorldCat is automatically selected for you, and we recommend keeping this setting. WorldCat is an online catalog which allows you to search the collections of libraries in your community and thousands more around the world. We will demonstrate this linking later in the tutorial. You may still add up to 3 additional libraries, including local libraries or former institutions to which you have alumni access. Second, please note that in order to retain these settings, you must turn on cookies. Click the help link for more information. There are additional settings you may want to enable. Proceed to the Search Results tab under Settings. We recommend checkmarking the box next to Open each selected result in a new browser window so as to not lose your original search results page. If you are a RefWorks user, select the radio button next to Show Links to Import Citations Into, and select RefWorks from the drop-down field. We will demonstrate how to use the RefWorks export feature later in the tutorial. Click Save to retain your new settings.
Let's move on to the search features of Google Scholar. The basic search box is available from the Google Scholar homepage. If you would like to explore advanced search options, you may do so by going to the drop-down menu on the left and selecting Advanced Search from here.
The Advanced Search allows you to search for a specific author or publication or designate a publication date range. Note that these options will also be available from your search results page. To begin searching, simply type your search terms into the box. Let's conduct a search for GMOs, or genetically modified organisms. If you need assistance constructing a search, please see the Preparing to Search section of our research process page, or contact the library for help. Now take a moment to explore your results page. You can see your search query in the top search box, the number of search results, and various ways to refine and sort your results. Note that not all results found through Google Scholar will be available in full text. Let's discuss some options for accessing full text through Google Scholar. If you successfully linked NCU Library to your Google Scholar search, you will see a full text at NCU hyperlink to the right of any resource which is available in full text through our electronic databases. Simply click the link to be taken directly to the full text resource. Note that you may be prompted to enter your student portal login credentials for authentication purposes before you are able to view the full text resource through our library. Other results may feature a link to a website or a PDF file. These are open access resources, meaning they are freely accessible and typically have few or no restrictions on copyright and licensing. Keep in mind, you still must properly cite them if you use them for your research. If you find a resource that does not provide any links to full text, then this resource is a prime candidate for interlibrary loan. There are a number of other important links to note which may be available for individual results. The first link you may see will indicate how many times this particular resource has been cited and by whom. Resources which have been cited the most times may feature seminal or groundbreaking research in the field and are likely worth exploring. You may click on the link itself in order to see a comprehensive list of the citing articles. Looking at the citing articles, or the articles which cited the original resource, can be an effective method for uncovering the latest research on your topic. You will be moving forward in time, given that the citing articles are building off of the research established in your original article. Articles are topically related to the parent result and will feature a range of topics that might explore or expand on this particular subject.
If you are a RefWorks user, you can click on the quotation mark icon to reveal options for exporting to different bibliographic management tools, including RefWorks. Clicking on the arrow icon available next to some results may reveal even more helpful links. If you are viewing a result for a book, the arrow icon will reveal the library search or WorldCat link.
WorldCat combs libraries near your location to see if that particular resource is available in hard copy. While it is not necessary to create a Google account in order to use Google Scholar, if you wish to save and organize resources, you will first need to create a Google account or sign in with your existing account. Click the Sign In link in the upper right-hand corner to sign in or to be prompted to create an account if you do not already have one.
Once you have created and signed into your Google account, you will be able to save documents using the star icon and access or organize them using the My Library link.
One last feature of Google Scholar we recommend taking advantage of is the ability to create an alert. Creating an alert ensures you do not miss out on the latest research related to your research topic. Google will periodically email you newly published papers that match your search criteria. It is not necessary to create or use a Google email address for this feature. You may enter any email address of your choice. We hope this tutorial on Google Scholar has been helpful. Remember to contact the library if you have any questions.